mind as plain as bamboo, calmly counting the years flow. Good morning, today is Saturday, May 18, 2024. Today in history, on this day 152 years ago, Bertrand Arthur William Russell, the British philosopher, mathematician, and logician, was born. Renowned for his contributions to analytic philosophy, Russell authored influential works such as History of Western Philosophy, Philosophical Problems, Analysis of Mind, and Analysis of Objects. His intellectual impact extended beyond philosophy to encompass fields like education, sociology, political science, and literature. Russell's legacy continues to inspire scholars across various disciplines. Qing Qiao, bridging the business world and delivering information to you. Welcome to today's Qing Qiao Morning News. Let's start with political updates. Slovak Prime Minister assassinated. Comprehensive news from Bratislava reports a startling incident on May 13. Prime Minister Fico of Slovakia was attacked while mingling with the crowd after a government meeting in Handlova. Witnesses heard four gunshots, leading to Fico being shot in the abdomen. Security guards swiftly evacuated him from the scene. Police have detained a suspect, with the Slovak Interior Ministry confirming it as an assassination attempt. Following the attack, Prime Minister Fico's condition was critical, prompting authorities to airlift him to a hospital in Banska Bystrica for urgent treatment, as stated by the Slovak government office. This marks the first assassination attempt in Slovak history. President Čaputová and leaders from various political backgrounds have strongly condemned the incident. Additionally, European Council President Michel, European Parliament President Mazura, German Chancellor Scholz, British Prime Minister Sunak, Dutch Prime Minister Rutte, NATO Secretary General Stoltenberg, and others expressed shock and conveyed wishes for Fico's speedy recovery. Fico, who secured his fourth term as Prime Minister in October last year, faced criticism during the campaign for his stance on Ukraine. He openly expressed sympathy for the Kremlin and criticized Western support for Ukraine, accusing Ukrainian Nazis and fascists of provoking Russian President Vladimir Putin to launch an invasion. Thailand, Cambodia, Japan mediate Myanmar crisis. In Yangon News, Thailand, Cambodia, and Japan recently contacted Myanmar's opposition and military government. They're altering their stance towards Myanmar, actively seeking mediation. Thai officials upped talks with Myanmar's opposition, including the Government of National Unity and ethnic armed groups. Ex-Thai PM Thaksin Shinawat privately asked to mediate Myanmar's conflict. Cambodia is also interested in mediating. Former Cambodian PM Hun Sen requested a call with Aung San Suu Kyi, but Myanmar's military declined. Nonetheless, Hun Sen plans to visit Myanmar soon to meet Min Aung Hlaing. Japan also stepped in, allowing a delegation from Myanmar's Government of National Unity and five ethnic armed groups to visit Tokyo soon. Secondly, we'll bring you updates on military-related news. Sri Lankan veterans in Russo-Ukrainian war, 16 dead. On May 15, Sri Lanka's Deputy Minister of Defense Tanakan stated that 288 retired Sri Lankan soldiers joined the Russia-Ukraine war as mercenaries, with at least 16 reported deaths. Dalabhoda, a lawmaker from the ruling party, revealed that most mercenaries were recruited to fight for Russia, allegedly deceived by promises of high salaries and non-combat roles. Authorities emphasized that recruiting Sri Lankans as mercenaries constitutes human trafficking, urging soldiers to avoid becoming victims. They maintain friendly relations with both Russia and Ukraine, engaging in dialogue with both foreign ministries to ensure the safe return of their citizens. Earlier, Sri Lankan police arrested two retired military officers suspected of illegally acting as recruitment agents for Russian mercenaries. Now, let's turn our attention to the latest economic news. Heat wave hampers Kampot pepper production. Agence France-Presse reports recent heat waves sweeping Southeast Asia, with record temperatures hitting the Philippines, Vietnam, Cambodia, and Thailand. In Cambodia, a six-month drought has left farmers struggling. Late April saw temperatures nearing 43 degrees Celsius, pushing farmers to their limits. Chin Luen, a farmer from Kampot province, known for Kampot pepper, shared that all 264 of his pepper trees perished due to heat and lack of water. Kampot pepper, renowned for its spicy flavor and floral aroma, is cherished by restaurants and chefs worldwide, fetching up to $200 per kilogram. The European Union granted it protected geographical indication status in 2016. Despite this recognition and increasing production, extreme weather this year may lead to the worst pepper harvest on record. Si Nu, chairman of the Kampot Pepper Promotion Association, anticipates a 50% drop in production this year, warning of shortages in 2025. Climate change constraints hinder farm expansion, compelling farmers to focus on sustaining existing pepper trees. Now, here is some important safety information. Philippines busts fraud center, deports 165 Chinese. On May 15, the Philippine Immigration Bureau announced that during a raid by the Philippine Anti-Crime Task Force in Bamban, Northern Philippines, hundreds of Filipinos and individuals involved in a case were apprehended. Foreigners are suspected of involvement in online fraud, with 165 Chinese implicated in fraudulent activities and lacking valid travel documents. These Chinese nationals will be deported to Shanghai, China, and permanently barred from entering the Philippines. Authorities also revealed that some individuals were coerced into working at the heart of the online scam and had their passports confiscated to prevent them from leaving. Across Southeast Asia, numerous online fraud centers operate, with criminal syndicates enticing, kidnapping, or coercing individuals into committing online fraud. According to the United Nations Office on Drugs and Crime, Southeast Asian criminal gangs have swindled billions of dollars worldwide. Canadian forest fires spread. According to Bloomberg News, wildfires in the southwest of Fort McMurray, a major oil sands producing area in Canada, have been burning uncontrollably for several days. A local evacuation alert has been issued, urging residents to prepare for evacuation. A nearby forest fire near Grande Prairie is also raging out of control. The resulting haze has spread across the Great Plains and the Great Lakes, enveloping cities like Cleveland, Buffalo, Toronto, and Ottawa. Fort McMurray faced a devastating wildfire in May 2016, forcing nearly 100,000 people to evacuate and causing extensive property damage. As the heart of Canada's oil sands industry, Fort McMurray produces around 3.3 million barrels per day, constituting two-thirds of Canada's total production. Finally, here's some intriguing cultural news. Vietnam's National Treasures Exhibition in Haiphong. According to the Vietnam News Agency, on May 11, the Department of Culture and Sports of Haiphong City inaugurated the National Treasure in Bien Collection exhibition at the Haiphong City Museum. The director highlighted Haiphong's possession of 21 national treasures, including 18 cultural relics from the In Bien Collection, curated by collector Tran Dinh Tang. Notably, this exhibition marks the first public display of gold objects from the shrine honoring General Lu Chan. The exhibition is organized around themes such as Dongshang culture, the independent feudal state period, Chinese ceramics, and Buddhist art. Approximately 500 artifacts dating from Dongshang culture to the 19th century, including 18 national treasures, were showcased. This event serves as an opportunity for Haiphong City to educate the public and both domestic and international tourists about the significance and cultural value of each exhibited object. It aims to contribute positively to the preservation and promotion of national cultural heritage. Financial newsletter. In March 2024, the U.S. Treasury Department's International Capital Flow Report revealed that Japan boosted its holdings of U.S. Treasury bonds by $19.9 billion, reaching $1.1878 trillion. This maintains Japan's position as the largest creditor to the United States. That's all for today's Tsing Chau Morning News. Thank you for listening.